Okay, so let us apply the variation method to one of the example, which is the harmonic oscillator. This actually exactly solvable method, but in order to understand the method, we are applying it on the harmonic oscillator. Actually, no need of applying variation method to harmonic oscillator because it is already an exactly solvable problem. Usually, the method applies to not exactly solvable problems. But here we just to learn to understand the power of or the effectiveness of variation method. We are applying that to harmonic oscillator. Then we will get some idea about how this method can be applied to some other problems. Okay, so in this we know what is Hamiltonian. Hamiltonian is p square by 2m plus half x square. And that can be written as minus h cross square by 2m dou square by dou x square in coordinate representation. P is minus h cross dou by dou x, and instead of k you can write m omega square. Now as a beginning, let us try two different functions as starting functions, or we call it as trial wave functions. Now I am considering two cases. Okay, so while choosing, the condition is that we know the wave function of the harmonic oscillator. It's when we choose the trial function, we should know the some of the details of the solution. Okay, then only we can have this better trial function. So according to our idea about the solution, you can guess some of the properties of solutions, because harmonic oscillator is oscillating between plus and minus limits, plus a and minus a, or like that. You can between the limits or 0 to a, something like that. So definitely the harmonic oscillator is bounded. It's a bounded case between these limits. So at infinity, what is the solution? At infinity, can you find the harmonic oscillator? No. At plus infinity or minus infinity, you can definitely say that solution is zero. No solution. You cannot find anything about the harmonic oscillator at plus infinity or minus infinity. That is safely you can assume. So that is one of the condition we choose when we choose the trial wave function. This condition you should impose into the trial wave function. So first condition is that wave function vanishes at plus or minus infinity. When position is at infinity, plus infinity or minus infinity, nothing about the, no information about the harmonic oscillator. So solution vanishes at infinities. Also, the probability density, which is the square of the wave function, modulus square of wave function, that is symmetric about x equal to 0. So the harmonic oscillator oscillates between equally on both sides of origin. So at the center point, you take it as 0. One extreme point is minus a, and the right side extreme point is plus a. So on both sides of 0, solution is same, symmetric, or no biasing for the solution on the left side or right side. Harmonic oscillator behaves in the same way on the left side of 0 and the right side of 0. So the probability density is symmetric on both sides of 0, origin. Is that the idea clear? These two are the inferences you can imagine before finding the solution. Okay. So So before we have not found any solution, but before finding the solution, we can have some imagination about the solution. We can have the true imagination about the solution. What will be the solution? What will be its nature? Okay. So harmonic oscillator is a bounded case. So at infinity, solution should vanish. Also, its oscillation is symmetric on both sides. No priority or no biasing on compression or extension. Or if it is a spring, there is no biasing for compression or stretching. When the linear case, non-linear case, there is difference. But in the case, symmetry loses in non-linear case. That we know. But in linear, when linear force is applied, linear restoring force is developed. Under the action of linear force, it is symmetric. Does it prefer compression or extension? Both are same. Behavior is same during compression or extension. So probability density is symmetric. Should be symmetric. These two are inferences you can imagine in advance. Well before finding the solution. Okay. So I will send the absentee. Who is absent? Okay. So apply with this idea in mind, you choose a trial wave function like this. First one is psi zero, which is a function of x, and you put some variation parameter alpha. So psi zero, you can choose it as some constant into, this is for normalization, that is the required one. So put some constant, then the above two ideas you put into practice, that is e to the power of minus half alpha x square. Okay, so x square ensures the symmetry. When x equal to plus x or minus x, x square is same. Okay, is the idea clear? I think you know the what is the okay what is I think this harmonic oscillator is everything is known to you, that is why I am not explaining too much. Do you want more explanation? If you want okay, annotate. See, these are the harmonic oscillator case. I can draw the okay. This is the harmonic oscillator spring connected with a mass M. Okay, and the mass is resting on a frictionless table, and this is our zero point. Okay, this is the mass. Okay, so frictionless table, you stretch this to plus A and release, then it will go to minus A. Okay, the oscillations will continue. So that is why that is what I told. Probability density is symmetric. Also, you cannot never see the mass at plus infinity and minus infinity. So satisfying these conditions, you choose this wave function, some constant into some just like some Gaussian wave function, e to the power of minus some, you put some alpha as a constant, then x square. X square ensures the even behavior of the function. Okay, so now you choose another wave function, another trial function psi 1, which is a function of x and beta. So instead of alpha, I have chosen beta here. So b into, now I have put an x here, b constant b into some x into e to the power of minus half beta x square. So here beta is the variational parameter, here alpha is the variational parameter. So why I have taken two functions, just to teach you how to suitably choose the trial wave function. After the end results, you can see that which one is correct in obtaining the ground state. So I will say the result in advance. You choose a psi zero like this, you will end up with the ground state. If you choose like this, you end up with the first excited state. Okay, so that is what I told. You should take care while choosing the trial wave function. Only thing we can do is you have some idea about the solution, some crude idea about the solution. If you understand this problem really well, what is happening here, this harmonic oscillator problem, you can have some crude idea about the solution. Solution means the position of this mass and the energy of this mass. Where this mass will be found? What will be its energy? In first state, second excited state, like the ground state. So first step in you applying trial variation method is you simply analyze the system. What is happening inside the system? What can be the nature of solutions? You think about that thrice until you are clear, everything is clear. You don't know the exact form of solution, but you will have some idea how to start with some crude solution or trial solutions. So here I have chosen two solutions, trial solutions. Okay, so alpha and beta are the variational parameters. You can include more parameters, alpha, beta, in the same one. You can include more one, alpha and A or B or C or D, like that. Here I have chosen only one parameter, and let us see what is the result. If it does not match with the experiment, you can add more parameters. Okay, always start from a simple case. Okay, so we have alpha and beta parameters. We have two trial wave functions. And let us see how these two trial functions leads to different solutions. So our one of the requirement is that we should have reached the ground state. Okay. So how this, I think I have to erase all these things. How to erase? Yes, I can erase all these things. Okay, so first thing you have to do that. So I think the idea of choosing the trial wave function is clear. That is the first step here. I will tell now. See the first step. Make a guess of the trial wave function. Make a guess. better a good guess. Don't go to a bad guess. Even if you do bad guess, no problem. You can correct it later. Matching with an experiment, you can correct later. You start from a trial wave function, suitably guessing. That takes into account all the physical properties, all the physical properties of the solution, or the circumstantial factors of the system. Okay, like symmetries, number of nodes, behavior at infinity or boundaries, like that. So that is the first step. Now we have did the first step. You choose a trial wave function, which is a function of position, then some variational parameters, alpha, beta, gamma. You can include more parameters, adjustable parameters, alpha, beta, gamma, like that. So, but we have included only one parameter in the first case, alpha, and one parameter in the second case, that is beta. So I have taken two trial wave functions, and at the same time, I will explain both. Actually, you don't need of two, but I am to understand some factors, I am choosing two different wave functions. And after choosing trial wave function, first step is you normalize the wave function. Put a psi star psi equal to 1 and find A. And psi 1 star psi 1 equal to 1, that is find B. So that is the first step. Okay. So that is why I put minus half here. So half comes two times. So half goes. So you get e to the power of minus alpha x square dx between limits minus infinity to plus infinity modulus s square equal to 1. Here modulus b square infinity integral into minus infinity infinity. Here x is in the not only in the power but also here also. So x square e to the power of minus beta x square dx equal to 1. So probability density is also symmetry here because x square comes on both the sides. Psi is not symmetric, but psi square is symmetric because probability density is psi square. So x square comes. So we have taken two aspects. At infinity, solution vanishes. Probability density is symmetric on both sides of the origin. So now you normalize these two equations. So both integrals are even because when you put x equal to minus x, it remains same. So these are even functions. So you can change the limits to 0 to infinity after including it, multiplying with a 2 here. So twice integral 0 to infinity. All things are same. Now you use some standard integrals. E to the power of minus x square dx is root pi. And x to the power of n, e to the power of minus alpha x dx is integral 0 to infinity is n factorial divided by alpha to the power of n plus 1. I think these integrals are known to you. Now, the integration. For normalization only, this is not anything about variation method. This is simply normalization, which we have already learned many times. So this is a variation, apply a change of variable, alpha x square equal to theta. Then takes it variations, take differentials, so d theta equal to alpha 2x dx d theta, so that dx equal to 1 by 2 alpha, then 1 by x, so 1 by x is you get from here x square equal to theta by alpha. So root of theta by alpha, 1 by x is just the reverse, alpha by theta, root of alpha by theta, d theta equal to this one. Now apply this normalization condition. Entire things is, I think these all you can do. Okay, I am not elaborating all this. But there are some minor mistakes. There may be some minor mistakes like a negative sign or something like that. You have to then you, that you have to notify me in the group. So who first notify it that you will get the credit. There may be some error, minimum, some many very very small errors or minus sign, something like that. So you check this normalization. You get A equal to alpha by pi to the power of 1 by 4. So in the first equation, in this first equation, you find the A. A, find the A, substitute here. Now find B by normalization. That is also given here. Put beta x square equal to theta. Now proceed in the same way. Everything is given here. You find the beta as this one. Substitute it there. So our wave function, trial wave functions becomes like this. I think these entire things you can check and find out any errors. I have hidden, given some minor, minute errors in this. So you can find out after doing that. Okay. So you obtain psi 0 and psi 1 like this. Now you apply the variation method. So here up to we have normalized. So I think your idea is clear. First you choose a trial wave function. Then it is natural to normalize. That is not a step. Naturally you have to normalize. We need a normalized trial wave function that we have did now. Now you find E0 using the first one. What is E0? E0 is the expectation value of the Hamiltonian. Hamiltonian we know, this is nothing but this one. Minus h cross square by 2m dou square, we have written earlier. Dou square by dou x square plus half m omega square x square is the Hamiltonian. Now on both sides, you integrate after multiplying with psi 0, you integrate this expression. That is evaluating the expectation value. Denominator is 1 because we have already normalized. So no need of writing the denominator. So alpha by pi to the power of half minus infinity to plus infinity, this e to the power of minus alpha half alpha x square. Here also it is, there is no complex conjugate. I is not there. Complex conjugate and this wave function are same. There is no imaginary part. So these two things are here. Now this is Hamiltonian H. Okay. Now this thing also I can, I think I can give to your homework. Let this e to the power of minus come on the from the right side only here. Here also it comes. Then you do this differentiation one times, then two times. Okay. Then you apply the limits after integrating. You apply the limits. Okay. You will get this equation. Okay. Now the entire things, I think you can verify. Again, some minute errors are there. I will ask if anybody has found that errors. So finally, you will end up with here. 1 by 4 m alpha into alpha square h cross square plus m square omega square. So you have to go write down all these things. Simplify this. You will end up with this equation, that is E0 for the variational parameter alpha, where we have used the first trial function. Now similarly, you do the second trial function, do the same one, you call it as E1, not E0, because you are going to get the first excited state, you call it as E1. Again the same thing, psi 1 h psi 1, do the simplification. You will get this equation, similar to this equation. This is while using psi 0 and this is by after using the psi 1. This is also your homework. you have to complete this integration. Similar to this one, you can do the integration, complete this, arrive at this result. And let me see who is going to complete it first. Okay. Now take the first one, E0. Find the derivative, dou E0 by, which is our variation parameter alpha. So dou E0 by dou alpha. Now differentiate this one with respect to alpha. Because alpha is our variation parameter, you find the dou E0 by dou alpha. This is E0. So here alpha is the variation parameter. So this alpha and this one of this alpha cancels. So you get h cross square by 2m, 4m. Now here 1 by alpha comes. So that means alpha to the power of minus 1. So that is nothing but alpha to the power of minus 2 divided by, sorry, this is differentiation. So alpha to the power of minus 1. So you get minus alpha to the power of minus 2. So minus alpha square in the denominator, along with the m square omega square by 4. 1 m cancels. Is that clear? This one, this step clear?
Yes, sir.
Now from this, you find, equate that to 0. Put the first derivative as 0, minima. I have already told here that is a condition. You apply the variation and put it as 0. So from that, you find what is alpha. Here only alpha square is there. So alpha, you find from this, find alpha. By cross multiplying, you find what is alpha. Call that alpha as alpha 0. So you get alpha equal to m omega by h cross. Okay. Now similarly from the second equation E1, you find the derivative of dou E1 by dou beta. Their variation parameter is beta. Then you differentiate this expression and equate to 0. Then from that you find what is beta, call it as beta 0 or beta 1, whatever you can call, m omega by h cross. That is also m omega by h cross. Now substitute back these values alpha and beta. First you substitute the value of alpha in the expression for E0. What is E0? E0 is this one. Here you substitute value for alpha, what we have found now. After applying variation, we obtained alpha. You put that alpha 0 here, you will get E0. Okay. So you get E0 alpha equal to 1 by 4m. You substitute that alpha 0 here. Okay. Here also one alpha is there. Alpha square is here also one alpha. You substitute for this alpha. So you get an expression like this. Okay. Now simplify that. You will get half h cross omega. Wonderful. This is the ground state energy of harmonic oscillator. Now you find the substitute beta in the expression for E1, in this one. Here beta square is here, beta is here. So you substitute for beta. Say beta is here and beta is here. Okay. Simplify. See, you will get 3 by 2 h cross omega. Wonderful. You reached the first excited state. Okay. See, we started from some trial wave functions and normalized that. Using that, you find the expectation value Hamiltonian, which is the energy. Then you minimized the energy with respect to that variation parameter. From that obtained value, you substituted back the expression in energy. Wonderfully, you obtain ground state energy here. Second, first excited state, first excited energy in the using that second trial function. Okay, see the effectiveness of variation method. So we considered two cases, two trial functions. So first trial function gave us ground state energy. Second wave function gave us, trial function gave us first excited state. So which is right? So we have to be very careful when choosing the trial wave function. Okay, sometimes you may end up with the first excited state also. That is what we told in the principle, that it is greater than or equal to E0. Sometimes you get E0, or sometimes you may get greater than E0, E1 also, E1, E2, like that. So note that by using variational method, we get exactly the ground state energy E0 here. And first excited state E1 in the case of LHO, linear harmonic oscillator, because this is natural, because we the trial wave functions I0 and Psi1 are exactly same nature of the actual eigenfunctions of H. We know the solutions of harmonic oscillator. So we, similar to that wave function, we chose the trial function. That is why we reached exactly here and here. Okay. So this implies that variational calculation does not always lead to the ground state. Sometimes it can give the first excited state also, or second excited state. Therefore, care should be taken to choose the trial wave function. This happened because Psi1 has a node at x equal to 0. Why this happened? See the solution, trial wave function where we have chosen. So we have chosen here. See, we put an x here. When x is equal to 0, this Psi1 vanishes. That means there is a node. And we know that there is no node for the ground state. Okay. Is that idea clear? First excited state, one node. Second excited state, two nodes. Like that. Node, number of nodes increases by one as we go from ground state. Ground state has no node. That idea also, if we should have included that idea also, then we can naturally assume that this is wrong. This will not never give the ground state energy, because when x equal to 0, Psi1 vanishes. That means that is a node. And we know there is no node for the ground state for any system, not only for a hydrogen atom or a linear harmonic oscillator. For any system, ground state have no nodes. And the number of nodes increase by one in each higher states. These are some of the basic ideas. So we didn't include that idea. That is why we choose this trial wave function, and we end up in the first excited state. So no problem in that, but just to understand our the policy, I have chosen the second trial wave function. So both will have infinitely vanishing at infinity, symmetric on both sides of origin, but this has a node at a ground state. So that cannot be allowed. So that is why this using this trial wave function, we end up with the first excited state. I think the idea is clear. If the idea is clear, I will go to the steps. What are the steps in applying variational method? If the example is clear, this will be also clear. To calculate the ground state energy, we need a fundamental energy, ground state energy. The steps are, first, make a trial wave function. You guess a suitable, proper trial wave function that takes into account all the properties of the system. Is that clear? Even the case of nodes, symmetries, number of nodes, behavior at infinity or behavior at the boundaries, every aspect you have to include in the your trial wave function. and still you are not sure about the any other further parameter for the properties which are not sure about, you can include further parameters, include adjustable parameters, any number of parameters you can include alpha, beta, gamma, etc. So psi is equal to a function of r, then there is no t, then alpha, beta, gamma, etc., which are the variational parameters. So this is the trial wave function. This is known as trial wave function. That is your first step. You properly choose the trial wave function. That is the simplest way of saying you properly choose the trial wave function. Now calculate the energy using whatever we told. Expect energy is the expectation value of Hamiltonian. You write H here. This psi should be here and here, and in the denominator also. If it is normalized, denominator is 1. So put, in order to make the denominator 1, you first normalize that one. So this is second step, calculate the energy. Okay. Now third step. Now vary, this is the main step. Varying the adjustable parameters alpha, beta, gamma, search for the minimum of E. How to do that? You find it first derivative and equate to that 0. Then you get alpha 0, beta 0, like that. How to find the minima? First derivative is 0. Maxima also first derivative is 0. Here you find the minima of E with respect to the variation parameter dou E by dou alpha equal to 0. That alpha you call it as alpha 0. Dou E by dou beta equal to 0. That value of beta is called, you call it as beta 0. Now substitute back the values of alpha 0, beta 0, etc. obtained from this equation back into this expression for E.